Welcome to Chem Help ASAP. This video reviews some of the reactions that demonstrate the idea of regiochemistry in a standard two-semester sequence of Organic Chemistry 1 and Organic Chemistry 2. The list of reactions covered in this video is not comprehensive, but it should cover most examples in most courses. If I left out an example of regiochemistry that you particularly enjoy, let me know in the comments section. If I get multiple suggestions, I'll make a follow-up video. Just to be clear, let's start by defining regiochemistry. So regiochemistry arises when the same reaction can occur on a functional group in different ways. The products from the multiple pathways are isomers. Specifically, they are regioisomers. Often, one isomer is formed in preference of another. That is, the reaction is regioselective. Sometimes you can change the reaction conditions to control which isomer you get. An example of regiocontrol. I'll be honest, when I was an undergraduate, I had been exposed to the idea of regioisomers, but I really didn't understand what it was or how the idea applied across multiple reactions. The idea didn't really sink in until I went to graduate school and had to teach it to students as a TA. Regardless, it is not a difficult concept, and I wish I had put a little more effort into understanding regioisomers. Okay, enough of that. Let's now see some examples. I'm going to present reactions in the order that they are presented in most textbooks, although many instructors, including me, work in a different order. Let's begin with the radical halogenation reaction. This is a substitution reaction in which a hydrogen is replaced with a halogen, a chlorine in this reaction. The reaction goes through a radical intermediate. I've drawn two isomeric products. These are regioisomers. One isomer, the left one, arises from removal of the hydrogen in the center of the molecule. The other isomer, the right one, arises from removal of any of the methyl hydrogens. The major product from this reaction is the left isomer. So this reaction, as drawn, is selective for the left regioisomer. How do we explain this selectivity? As it turns out, the selectivity of this reaction is driven by the radical intermediate that arises from formation of the radical at the central carbon. This is a tertiary radical, and it leads to the left product. The tertiary radical is relatively stable. The right product arises from a less stable primary radical. So the more stable tertiary radical forms more readily and leads to the major product. Let's see another reaction with regiochemistry. The E2 elimination is another reaction that demonstrates regioisomers. When an alkyl halide is treated with a strong base, sometimes multiple different isomers are possible. This reaction initiates with removal of a beta hydrogen relative to the halide. The starting material shown has two different types of beta hydrogens, one on the left and one, actually any of three, on the right. Removal of the left beta hydrogen gives the left product, the SATSEF product. Removal of the right beta hydrogen gives the Hoffman product. As it turns out, the identity of the base allows one to control which regioisomer is formed. With typical strong bases like sodium hydroxide and alkoxides like sodium methoxide or sodium ethoxide, the SATSEF product is favored. The SATSEF product is more thermodynamically stable. And typical bases, though strong, are weaker and favor the lower energy pathway that gives the more stable product. Potassium T p-butoxide is both a bit stronger and quite bulky. These qualities minimize collisions at the more hindered, more substituted beta hydrogen, so a greater amount of product arises from removal of the less substituted beta hydrogen. This favors the Hoffman product, even though the Hoffman product is less thermodynamically stable. So the regioselectivity of E2 elimination can be controlled depending on the base used in the reaction. How about alkene hydrations, specifically acid-catalyzed reactions in water? Alkene hydrations begin with an acid protonating an alkene. In theory, you can add the proton to either side of the alkene, and this is the start of the regioisomeric outcome of the reaction. So you can get two isomeric carbocations. In this case, the top one is secondary and the bottom is tertiary. The tertiary is more stable and favored under these conditions. The cation is attacked by water and ultimately leads to the alcohol product, specifically the Markovnikov product, while the other regioisomer, which arises by the secondary carbocation and called an anti-Markovnikov product, is possible. It is disfavored because of the poor stability of the secondary carbocation. In this reaction, there is no way to favor the anti-Markovnikov alcohol. The regioselectivity is unavoidably driven by the stability of the carbocation intermediate. Here is another alkene hydration. This does not involve acid and carbocations. Instead, it involves an alkene hydroboration followed by an oxidation. Instead of being controlled by carbocation stability, the regiochemistry of the hydroboration is controlled by steric hindrance around the alkene. The BH2 group preferentially reacts on the less hindered side of the alkene based on sterics. Once the C-B bond has formed, the regiochemical outcome has been determined. The oxidation simply exchanges the boron with an oxygen. So the hydroboration oxidation affords a product that corresponds to the anti-Markovnikov product and is driven by steric hindrance around the alkene carbons instead of carbocation stability, which was the deciding factor in the acid-catalyzed hydration. Another reaction with regiochemical implications is an epoxide opening. Epoxides are typically opened with either weak nucleophiles, often with acid, or strong nucleophiles, generally basic conditions. In either case, two regioisomeric products are possible. Note that the left regioisomer has the epoxide oxygen on the less substituted side, and the new methoxy group has added to the more substituted carbon. In the right regioisomer, the epoxide oxygen is on the more substituted side of the epoxide, and the methoxy group is on the less substituted side. The acidic, weak nucleophile conditions favor the left regioisomer. The acidic conditions go through a protonated epoxide, and the cationic intermediate tends to be attacked at the more substituted side of the epoxide. Under basic conditions, there is no protonation. The nucleophile, now methoxide anion, must force open the neutral ring, and attack favors the less substituted side to give the right regioisomer, which is favored under basic conditions. So, in this reaction, simply changing the pH of the reaction can give control over the regiochemical outcome of the epoxide ring opening. Electrophilic aromatic substitution, EAS reactions, can give different regioisomers. The substitution involves replacement of a CH on an aromatic ring with an electrophilic group. A monosubstituted aromatic ring, like the starting material shown, can give three different regioisomers corresponding to substitution of the electrophile in the ortho, meta, or para position relative to the ring substituent. For EAS reactions, the regiochemical outcome is generally controlled by the electronic nature of the R group. If the R group is an electron donating group, the carbocation intermediates leading to the ortho and para products are favored, with the para product typically winning out because of steric repulsion in the ortho product. If the R group is an electron withdrawing group, the carbocation intermediates leading to the ortho and para products are destabilized, and the meta regioisomer is favored. Regioisomeric enolates are also possible. In the middle of the slide is a non-symmetrical ketone. When this ketone is treated with a base, there are two possible outcomes. The deprotonation can involve the alpha hydrogens on the left or the alpha hydrogens on the right to give two possible isomeric enolates. I tend to favor drawing enolates as carbanions, but these enolates are better understood by considering the oxyanion resonance forms. The left enolate is more stable because the alkene is more highly substituted. For weaker bases like sodium hydroxide and alkoxides, the left more stable enolate is favored. With strong hindered bases like LDA, the less substituted alpha proton is more available to react, and the right enolate tends to form. So in this case, the regiochemistry of enolate formation can be controlled through careful selection of the base. The last reaction is the Diels-Alder cycloaddition. In general, with the Diels-Alder, the diene bears an electron donating group, and the dienophile has an electron withdrawing group. These groups provide a point of reference for visualizing the different possible regioisomeric products. In the top reaction, the cycloaddition forms the 1,2 product. In the bottom reaction, the cycloaddition forms the 1,3 product. Which one is favored? The regioselectivity of this reaction is determined by the electronic bias of the electron donating and electron withdrawing groups. The electron donating group is electron rich and polarizes the diene in this manner. Note that these are not formal charges, but instead partial charges to demonstrate the electronic bias of the diene. The electron withdrawing group is electron poor and polarizes the dienophile in this manner. In the top pathway, the opposite charges align and the 1,2 product is favored. In the bottom pathway, identical charges align and repel each other, so the bottom regioisomer is disfavored. In the Diels-Alder, you cannot easily control the regiochemical outcome. The favored product is an inherent result of the electronic bias of the diene and dienophile. That is our last regiochemistry example. Hopefully you have a better feel of regiochemistry after seeing multiple reactions that feature the ideas of regioselectivity. That was a quick review of regiochemistry. Please leave a comment, leave a like, or subscribe to the channel. Questions, of course, are always welcome. Take care.